Most New York State residents feel that the state bureaucracy has grown too large, and it's again been another focal point of both of your campaigns. And agencies have also become too powerful. Now imagine you're an assemblyman, you're up in Albany. What do you recommend, and what would you do to reduce the size of state government? And what state agencies, if any, would you limit their what might be perceived as their overreaching powers? Okay, Kyle?
Sure. The first step is looking at that list of unfunded mandates that the Mandate Relief Council put forward and identifying all those that should be eliminated, eliminating them, and then seeing the impact that that's going to have on various state agencies. Because the reality is, when you implement some of these changes, there are people that regulate the implementation of various state laws and state mandates. If you get rid of the mandates, you just won't, frankly, need as many people doing that, and you won't need the agencies as big. All too often, you see agencies grow just for the sake of growing to police the municipalities for the laws that they have. I've had extensive interaction with the DEC, and recently in the Village of Goshen, we reached a settlement with the DEC and the Attorney General's office that was very fair for both New York State and our municipality. And we actually had a very good working relationship at the end. But not other municipalities are as fortunate. And, you know, working with any of those bureaucracies is very challenging. So we really need to identify the areas that aren't needed. If it's just someone working to protect a mandate because it's there, they shouldn't be there, quite frankly. Thank you.
Thank you. Colin.
Thanks, Frank. No, and I'm glad my opponent brought up D.C. I think that's one area, at least on D.C., we agree that we see local examples where D.C. has needed to protect the taxpayers, but also where it needs to be reined in. I mean, when Village of Goshen taxpayers are getting whacked at least three times, fine in defending fines and by the cost of the Attorney General, we see where this can take us. But more importantly, when it comes to state government or state agencies, I like to look at Assemblyman Steve Katz across the river. He's introduced a great piece of legislation that, if elected, I'd be one of the first pieces that I want to sign on to. It's first starting with reforming the state government by limiting the legislature, cutting benefits of state legislators, both pay and otherwise, and also limiting the legislative term, getting the same amount of work in, but making them actually do it in full days in the beginning of the year. Cutting back the printing costs, cutting back the cost of operation, simply cutting back the cost of putting the lights on in the Capitol can save at least $150 million at the bare minimum, if not many other hundreds of millions of dollars. And we want to go back into history. We can look at good old Governor Al Smith, who gave us Port Authority and some of these other quasi-government agencies that have been running wild. They're government when they want funding, but they're private when they want accountability. They need to be reined in, they need to be audited, and they need to be trimmed down.
Kyle?
Sure. I would say in terms of, because my opponent brought it up, he's good at reading off his note cards and dropping names from people across the river, but in terms of the Village of Goshen, he just doesn't have his facts right there, because really our fines could have been in the millions of dollars. We worked out a fine of $25,000 and a $300,000 environmental benefit project, which is going to have a new recycling program for the Village of Goshen, and that was done with our village attorney that's on retainer. So when he says whack three times, I don't really know what that means, and I think maybe you should study local issues a little more than looking across the river.
Colin, and then your response.
Thank you, Frank. And listen, anyone can go and get the public documents. And when there's over 70 plus violations that are directly responsible before, there needs to be accountability for that. But again, I think we want to continue moving forward and reform, working with the agencies that need to protect us, but also reforming them so they do the best work.